Hey everyone, today I'm just going to show you the basics to creating an eye look. I did a pretty dramatic one, but there's like 3 or 4 super easy steps that you can follow and make your own eye look. So if you're interested to see how to do this, then just keep watching. Alright, so the first step whenever you do eyeshadow, especially for horse shows, is to prime. So I'm taking the Urban Decay Primer Potion. Basically, priming your eyes or your face, it should all be the same. It's going to help make your makeup last longer, and for instance, for eyeshadow, it's going to make your eyeshadows more vibrant. So I just put this on from the lid all the way up to my brow bone. Next, you just want to set the primer with like a nude colored eyeshadow. You can use a translucent powder. I use the Wet n Wild Brulee eyeshadow. It's 99 cents and it is amazing. So you want to set primers because the point is to make your eyeshadow go on smooth and look nice throughout the day, that kind of thing. So if you just go in right away and start blending into the crease or just putting eyeshadow on, it's going to stick and like drag and not go on smoothly. So by putting this down, it gives it like a nice base to work over. Alright, so the next thing I do is go in with a blending brush into the crease. So I have 3 different blending brushes right here that I love. This one is a Sonia Kashuk. It came out of a holiday kit. This is the Morphe M504 and then this is the Morphe E23. So they're all fluffy blending brushes. This one's a little bit more narrow, this one's more fluffy, and this one has a flat top. So they're all going to do basically the same thing, but I like to use one of these brushes to go in with the crease color. So I'm going to go in with the Morphe M504. And for me, I like to use neutral colors or cool tones in my crease. You can go in with a warm tone color, which is going to have more of that like orangey color. A cool tone is going to be more like on the gray side. So I'm going in this with this color right here. This is the color Tease by Urban Decay. And just put that right into the crease. So the crease of your eye is like where your eye socket is. And then with a big fluffy brush, it's really easy because it just blends it out for you. So I just put that in my crease from outer edge all the way to the inner edge, going back and forth and then doing little circular motions to blend it out. This is going to add a little bit of definition and it's also going to make it easier for our other shades to blend into. So that's what a lot of people call this, a transition color. So it's going to help if I put a darker color here, it's going to help transition and make it like a gradient effect all the way to the brow bone. So depending on the eye shape you want to go for, I have like an almond shaped eye and I like to keep my looks a little bit more round. So when I go in with product, I put it right into the middle of my crease and work from there so that the most color is deposited into the center of the crease. If you wanted more of a cat eye look, you could keep it on the outer corner. But I just like to keep mine a little bit more rounded. Okay, so now our transition color is down, or our crease color. So on a very basic eye, the next step I would do is put something on the outer corner. So typically you take a darker shade, like a dark brown, you could do black, anything like that. And for outer corners, I like to use something in the shape like this. So it's like, sorry, all my brushes are dirty, but they're all kind of like a pinched blending brush. So if you look at it from the side, you can see that they're all pinched down here. But then when you turn it, it's a wide, it's like a paddle shape, and then they're all really fluffy. So that helps to help blending out. My favorite is the MAC 217. It's an awesome, awesome brush. You can use it for a ton of things. But then an alternative, which is very similar, almost a dupe, is the Morphe M433. And then another one that's just different is a Crown, I think it's called the Crown Double-Ended Infinity Brush. It doesn't actually have a name on it, but it's double-ended. So today I'm going to use the MAC 217. I'm taking the color Lost by Urban Decay to put that on the outer corner. It has a little bit of a sheen to it. You can use a matte color, which is not going to have any sheen or sparkle to it. Or you can go in with something like this. And I'm going to keep it on the outer kind of third. This is what people call the V of your eye. So if they say put it into the V of your eye, that's what they're talking about. I personally like to just keep it on like the outer third rather than just into the V. By putting this color on the outer third of your eye, it's going to give it more of an elongated cat eye look. It's also going to give it some depth. As you can see, it gives my eye a lot more dimension than on this side. This one's just like hey, whatever. And this one has like a little bit of a party going on the outer corner. And then with a brush like this, and this is why I love it so much, is I can put down the color and then I can also blend because it's still fluffy. So I just take whatever's on my brush and blend it up into the crease. And then I'm just going to go back to my first blending brush, and this is the trick to blending out your eyeshadow. Go back and forth between your brushes, and I almost always go back to my first blending brush. So I'm just going to blend out this edge here. And as you can see, this eye is a lot more rounded than this eye. So what, like I said, I like to keep my eye more rounded. I'm going to take whatever's left on the brush and just bring it into the middle of the crease, kind of. I'm going to pick up the first color Tease on my blending brush just to help this blend out a little bit smoother. And I'm taking all my eyeshadows very high up to my brow bone just because I like to give it that appearance that I have a lot of eyelid space, which I do, but I want it to look bigger. You can keep it more down in your crease if you want. You can bring it up this high. You can bring it up all the way to your brow bone if you want. Whatever floats your boat. So the next step I typically do to kind of soften the look is a brow bone color. You can do a matte color, you can do something with sheen, you can do something super shimmery. My personal favorite is the color Skimp from the Urban Decay Naked Basics 2 palette. It just has a little bit of a sheen to it. And I take a really, really small but fluffy brush and I put this on my brow bone. I always start right at the highest point in my brow bone, just because that's where you want, naturally the light is going to hit that point more, so that's where I put the most product, if that makes sense. It's going to reflect just like where the sun would hit. Then I just go back with my blending brush and blend those two together. So next you pretty much go in with a lid color. You can do more steps, but this is a very basic kind of how-to. So I like to go in with something that's very flat and packed. This is a synthetic brush by Marsk. I got this in an Ipsy bag, and I actually get a lot of brushes I love from my Ipsy bag. But what you can do is you can either take a matte shadow. If you're just doing your simple eye, you can put a lighter color on your lid all the way into your inner corner. Or what I'm going to do today is a shimmery color to add more dimension and everything. So I just want to show you guys a little trick. If you want your shimmery shades to pay off and be more metallic, you can spray your brush with water, or what's really going to work best is the MAC Fix Plus. This is just going to give it more of that metallic finish. So I'm doing that on my brush, and then I'm taking the color Midnight Cowboy Rides Again from Urban Decay, and I'm just going to put this on my lid. And as you can see, we want to keep the dark color on the outside, and we want to stay below the crease. So my crease is right here. And then I'm staying below it so that the most dimension is on the center of the eye. So now you can see that it has, it makes, when you put that shimmery shade right on the center of your lid, it brings your like eyeball forward, if that makes sense. This one's just flat, it has no shimmer on it, so it's not enhancing the shape of my eye at all. But this one, it brings the center part forward and makes it brighter. And then what I like to do is go back to my MAC 217 and just help blend out the edge a little bit so it's not just a straight line. And now, again, there's more options. You can do on the inner corner right here, you can do just a matte white shade, you can do a shimmery shade, whatever you want. Just for drama today, I'm gonna go ahead and do a white shimmery shade. So this is Polyester Bride from Urban Decay, and you can use your finger for this. I would, but I have nails on, so it's really hard to get like right in there. So I'm just gonna use a little brush. Actually, I'm just gonna go for it and do my finger. I've been reminiscing all the good times. So putting a really bright white shade in the corner of your eye is going to help open your eye and brighten it, make you look a little bit more awake. Then I'm going to take my blending brush and help blend this out a little bit, because my nail, it puts it up a little higher than I like, but that just blends it right away. Alright, so now I did my under eye concealer, and I'm in the midst of doing a highlight and contour video while I do this, so I'm kind of going back and forth. It's crazy, I know. So I'm just going to finish up my lower lash line. There's a ton of ways you can do a lower lash line. I like to pretty much do the same steps that I did on top on my lower lash line. Like I have the shimmery shade, sometimes I'll put that in the middle of my lower lash line and the dark on the outside. You can just do the dark on your whole lower lash line, whatever you want to do, it's totally up to you. But I'm just going to do what I did on the top on my lower lash line. So the first thing I like to do is take our transition shade, which was Tease, on a fluffy pencil brush like so. This is again from Sonia Kashuk, her fall holiday, or I guess it wouldn't be holiday, a fall kit. I also really like to use these two little brushes, which are dirty right now, is why I'm not using them. They're from the Sonia Kashuk holiday set, so it's just a really little flat brush. It's not a shader brush, but it's like a little tiny flat brush. And then a little tiny pencil brush, and then I'll go in with the fluffy pencil brush. But today I'm just gonna make it really smoky. So I take that transition shade and I'm gonna keep this on the outer half of my eye. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the MAC 217. I'm not picking up any additional product. I'm using what's already on it. And I'm just going to run that on the lower lash line. And I personally, on this look, I'm making it very round. So I'm trying to connect my lower lash line with my top eyeshadow. I also like to make it really smoky on my lower lash line, because once I put mascara on, it really takes away from what's on your lower lash line. So I like to make it smoky right away, and then that way it'll peek through your mascara. Next, I'm gonna use the same fluffy pencil brush, but I'm gonna spray it with some brush cleaner. This is the Sephora Mini Citrus Brush Cleaner. I cannot say that. So basically it just dries right away, which is nice when you're transitioning between eye colors or you want to use the same brush, but you can't, whatever. So now I'm going to take MAC Fix Plus and I'm going to use that shimmery shade, which is Midnight Cowboy Rides Again. I'm going to put this on the middle and inner half of my eye. And then I'm going to use my finger and just put the white polyester bride shade in the inner corner again. And I got a little bit of that Midnight Cowboy Rides Again right here, so I'm just taking a Q-tip and wiping it away. So that's basically it for eyeshadow. You could not do eyeliner, you could not do any eyeliner in your waterline or anything and just leave it, but I'm going to go ahead and do it. So I like to use a nude color eyeshadow a lot in my lower lash line just to open my eyes a little bit. This is the Bright Eyes Eye Enhancing Eyeliner by Skin Cosmetics. And this just makes you look more awake, it opens your eyes more, all that good stuff. And then I like to go in with a black eyeliner on my tight line, which is going to be right up under your lashes, basically like the inside of your eyelid. And I use the Marc Jacobs Highliner, the black shade, because it is so creamy, but it stays on all day. And this will just add the effect that your lashes have a lot more volume. And I'll show you the difference, you'll see. So you see how this one is so much more defined than this one, just from that little bit of eyeliner? That is an awesome place to stop if you're not comfortable with using liquid eyeliner or a winged eyeliner. I'm not going to do a winged eyeliner today just because the look is pretty dramatic already. But let me finish up this eye. What I'm going to do for eyeliner is just a thin line along the lash line. Nothing, no wing, no nothing crazy, just to add a little more definition. That is like the word of the day. And I'm using the Kat Von D Tattoo Liner. This is my favorite eyeliner. It makes it super easy to get that wing if you're doing a wing. Are you down? Did it Alright, so this is the finished look. I just did my highlight and contour, which there will be a video, and my lips, and then I put lashes and mascara on. These are the Wispies by Ardell. They're my go-to, and then I use the It Cosmetics, what is it called? Superhero mascara. I put that on my lower lash lines and it gives you that really nice like doll look. So I hope this helped you guys understand kind of how to do some eye looks. It's the same steps for all eye looks. It's just different colors and you can like play it up or play it down, that kind of thing. But this is a good go-to look for an all-around show. And then the nude lip goes with any outfit, so it's pretty basic. You can wear this with anything. So I hope this helped you guys on how to learn how to do some eye looks and give you something to wear to just your all-day show or whatever it may be. If you have not subscribed, please do so. The link is down below and it'll tell you when I post new videos and all that good stuff. And I will see you in my next video. Bye guys!